Next to go will be Ros Canter, young Ros Canter with All-Star B. It's a lovely bay horse that she's campaigned at four-star level.
But yeah, Ros is super. Yeah, yeah. She, I know, trained with Judy Bradwell for a while and really, really knows how to ride on the flat.
Yeah, she does. So Ros Canter with All-Star B. Been a pretty progressive start so far.
Been solid, though. Very rhythmical. This half pass is a bit trailing. You can see the quarters there. Could have been a little bit more.
You'd nearly just want to slightly more wrapped around the inside leg a little more there. Easy for me to say with long legs.
And she looks like she's got short legs on a big horse. She looks like she's got short legs on a very big horse, this Rosalind. The walk, I think, is very good quality. Got good march.
What are they looking for in the walk, Mark?
Relaxation first and foremost, which it has. Then we're looking for overtrack, where its hind leg should overtrack where the foreleg had been. And that was, could have had a bit more overtrack, but it was imprinting. But it was the relaxation that I think should get the mark for that. And one of the judges agreed with me. And it picked up to the medium walk very nicely.
Yeah.
Well, this combination was seventh here back in 2014 in the CIC three-star. So a combination that's got good three-star form. They were, as I said, entered at Babington. They did the dressage and then withdrew after the dressage, sadly. Studied sports science at Sheffield University. And as you said, Jesse, trained and worked for Judy Bradwell for a number of years.
Wow, that was a beautiful flying change. You know, really off the ground there, which is what you want.
It should.
Yeah, for an event horse, definitely. Yeah. Yeah, and there we go. There we go.
All four of them,
yeah.
Jesse.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I would have gone 8.5 there.
So would I. You know. I'd have gone 9, having what I'd seen in the morning and given sevens for.
And is that indicative of what we're watching now, the test that we saw this morning with the flying changes, the quality of the flying changes from now?
Yeah, because this morning we saw some nice ones, but they were very just normal, in the normal range, and the seven was fine. Then we've then come and seen this, for me, was 2 marks higher than what we gave sevens for this morning. They gave, not me, sevens for. So I'm like, I must reward up.
Yes.
But...
And there's, you know, you get 10 to 1 as your sort of judging scale, and I like it when a judge uses those marks. You know,
I don't think they go low enough, and I don't think they go high enough. So let's all stick in the middle. They'll say there was a little bit lost on roundness, but it was very expressive, very on the aid. It should be a 7.5. As we wait with bated breath. Okay.
Yeah, that's about right. Yeah.
Well, the best dressage this horse has had is a 40.2. That was at Burley in 2015. And she's trending around the 44 mark at the moment. She's putting in a solid, solid performance.
I mean, he's the first horse we've seen in a double bridle, which is very interesting, because 10 years ago we'd have seen more in a double bridle than a snaffle. And I think it's nice, actually, because a lot of horses are not designed to wear double bridles. This horse is. His mouth was really good. The contact was really good. She probably feels she gets a little bit more suppleness and throughness in his jaw. When, you know, I like horses in snaffles if you can. But this horse was lovely in the double.
Well, I think we've got the dressage score now for Ros Canter, and it's 43.3. Goes into second place, just one mark behind Pippa Funnel and Mirage Dell.
So I'm joined by Rosalind Canter. Ros, you must be delighted with All-Star B's performance in the dressage.
Yes, I'm really happy with him. He just went in there, put his head down and did the job, so we're really happy.
And tell us, it must be very exciting to be involved in the ERM series and at somewhere like Bramham, with the backdrop it provides, the cross-country course influential, it's a great weekend ahead, isn't it?
Oh yeah, it's really exciting for us to have this new class, to have something to aim for, and for it to be at Bramham is a bonus because it's just one of my favourite events. It's so friendly, but a big occasion, and it's just really good, yeah.
And of course, your horse owned by Caroline Moore, I believe.
Yeah, we jointly own him now, right.
And I mean, a big thing to have somebody like Caroline helping you.
Yeah, she's absolutely fantastic because she's been a bit of a mentor to me now, but she's also a great friend and she's just fully supportive of everything I do, and she lets me get on with what I think's right, but she's there to step in and give me advice, so it just works brilliantly.
And you scored 43, so you're into second place at the moment, provisionally.
Yeah, that's brilliant. Again, I mean, as usual, he just did the most consistent test, and that's what All-Star B does. I mean, he's not the flashiest horse, but he's just so rideable, and he just always gives his best, so we're really happy.
Well, the very best of luck for the rest of the weekend, Ros. Good luck.
Thank you.